body testing, and first time I was invited to present our department for Romania. It was one solution in the scope, so I had to talk about one of the products that we work internally. Going forward, I realized that the information about our ultimate department will be located, so you will not have a good visibility of what we are doing there. So I decided to present you two solutions of our department. Okay, so first I want to have give you a first introduction of the what our department is working. So we are building the application which address the user from end to end point of view. So we start from the provisioning part, the user subscription, and step by step with the back-end servers we keep our database and all stuff. Go farther with the bearers, covering all the bearers, Wi-Fi, 3G, going far to the 4G LTE. And also we have the first start of in DVB-H and DVB-SH in broadcasting. And we address application targeting all available devices from mobile handsets, smartphones, to tablets, PC clients, and TV handsets. Okay, and we address various number of applications with different features and functionalities. This is, let's say, just a snapshot where you can see that we cover all the environment, the entire ecosystem. Going further, I will start with one of the solutions, which is named Home Media Sharing. The name is same. It's about user-generated content. Each of the users has the possibility to upload, let's say, information from pictures, videos. There are multiple, let's say, content providers which allow the users to upload content like YouTube. And as any solution, any product starts from the user needs. So in this case, the user has access to the content, or it has the content, but sometimes the user wants to see the content from the PC, wants to see it from the mobile, or directly on the TV. Or going farther, the user has some content on the PC, some content he uploads on the, let's say, on the YouTube, but each content, each media is in different place. And the user wants to access it from one side, all the content that he owns, or all the content that is available on the market. Also, the user wants to may choose to play music or videos in the house once on the, I don't know, on the TV or in the bedroom on a different device. So, considering all these user needs, based on this, we started to develop this solution, let's say, not just an application, it's a solution which put all the content in one place and distribute it on all the devices. So, here is a altogether presentation of the solution. So we have aggregator of the content where the user is able to different kind of content, and also to access content from YouTube or different social networks. Once the user has access to the content, he is able to play on each of the devices he owns in home. This is through the DLNA protocol. So if the user has different devices who are connected to this protocol, he is able to play it on iPhone, iPad, on Android devices, tablets, and smartphones, and also on the TV, through the setup box, also on the radio, and any other device. So now the user has access to any content, but also is able to play on any device he wants to play. So the dream comes true for the user. This is I will come back a little bit later to this solution at the end of the presentation. So now I want to go to another solution of our department. It's named Online Movie Stream Video Platform. So as you've seen before, the previous solution is an user. It's mainly a user generated content aggregator and allowing the user to play on devices. This second solution is addressed mostly to the different operators, so it's a business-to-business solution where the operators can provide or give the user access to different live TV channels, video-on-demand content, DVRs, and personal video recordings. Again, like on the other application, once the user subscribes, let's say, to this solution, he is able to play the solution on various devices, starting from the smartphones, going to the tablets and TV sets, and also on the PC. The solution is based on the JQuery technology, and for the web mobile client, we target HTML5 technology. So the user has access from different devices to different kind of content offered by the operator. To go back to the, let's say, a little bit coming back to the history of the this application. Years ago, we offered heterogeneous applications. So we had one department working on the IPTV, building application for setup boxes. Another department working on the web TV application, and our multimedia department working on the mobile TV application. Of course, this kind of approach is not take benefit for the user because he has to subscribe to different applications, different technologies. So, from that came the idea to have one single application, one single homogeneous application, which will offer to the user the possibility to have the same look and feel on different devices. So we built this online mobile TV, online multi-screen platform, which offers to the user the possibility to access the content from different devices. So the user has to sign only to one place and it will have access to any device. Just to give you some examples of the use of this homogeneous approach of application. For example, if the user starts watching a movie while he's in traveling by train, let's say, he can start watching a movie and as soon as he arrives home, he can choose to continue playing from a defined bookmark to a TV set. So once he's at home, he can choose to watch a movie on the TV. Or another example of using facility of this application is to have a preferred show which is running at the same time when you are not at home to watch it, so you are able to order remotely through this application to record the movie and to benefit to watch the show when you are home. So there are different approaches, different scenarios where the user takes advantage of this homogeneous look and feel and subscription of the application. As I mentioned before, we use this homogeneous concept, UI concept, so the user is not forced to adapt to the look and feel of the application depending on the device he's connected to. So once he knows the application which runs on the mobile, for example, it's very easy for the user to access any other application which is running on the PC or on the TV handset or on the tablet. This is very important for the user to access the content. Now we have a question having these two applications, user generated content and let's say the operator content. What's the next step for us to be closer to the user, to offer to the user more than he has now? Is you have a convergent solution of the homogeneous sharing and of the multi-video platform, multi-screen video platform. What does it mean? It means that with one application, one single application, the user can access any content from that he uploaded from any device and also to share it with friends to see the different content from any of the friends, but in the same time he can watch different TV live shows or movies or to watch any video on demand he wants. So the user has the mobile multimedia, the multimedia experience in the one place, in one single place, in one subscription. This is the solution that we are working right now. Before concluding, this approach is a win-win deal situation for all the three players, let's say, for the service providers, for the content providers, and for the consumers. Each of these players has advantage of this homogeneous solution. Service providers, that they can offer the solutions on any device. And also to use it as a business model for all the players in the industry. Also for the content providers, that the content they are providing to the user is accessible from any device. Doesn't matter, they don't have to provide content for TVs or mobiles. They provide the content once and the user can access from any device. And also for the consumers, for the end users, they are able to have access to all the contents from all the places, even if they are traveling from the mobile, even if they are home from the PC or from the TV. This is the best benefit for the users and for all the other players. That's why we call it a win-win deal for everyone.
Okay, thank you, Gabi. Do you have any questions, please, before the coffee break? Come on, please.
When can we expect the service and what will it cost?
When you... For the question of when you can expect the service, it's 2012. It's planned for 2012. And the cost of the server, of the service itself, is depending fully on the service providers, on the operators. We offer the solution, and the service providers deal with the cost. Normally, the simple service application, normally they are free on the market. But when the benefit for the subscribers, for the operators, let's say, is for buying the content if you want it, which is fair. But the application itself is free, no matter.
I'm sorry, so who would be service providers? You have to be like internet providers or mobile phone operators?
Okay, thank you.